Hello students, I am here with another video from the chapter Reproduction in Plants from class 7th NCERT book. Now before starting today's video, I would like to tell you all that till now what all things we have discussed in this chapter. So we have discussed about the concept of reproduction, where I told you about the definition that reproduction means it is a process by which a plant is going to generate its own type, its own kind, because of the presence of seeds, and sometimes seeds are also not required. Now based upon these this feature, that whether a plant is going to reproduce with the help of seed or it is going to reproduce with the help of without the seeds, so these based upon this fact, the reproduction is of two type. It is the sexual as well as asexual mode of reproduction. Now in asexual mode of reproduction in plants, it takes place without the help of the seeds, whereas in sexual reproduction it is going to take place without the with the help of the seeds. Okay, and then lastly, I have also discussed about the two main types of asexual mode of reproduction, where we have seen about budding and the fragmentation. And in budding, we have seen that one single parent plant is there, that is a fungi. It is going to give rise to a new small bud like outgrowths, and they are going to develop and form a new fungi. So we have seen this budding formation, and this budding in the fungi, that is called yeast, and this yeast is helpful in the baking industries. Okay, and then we have also seen the fragmentation, which takes place in the algae, where this algae is going to be broken down into parts, that is known as the small parts, or it is also known as the fragments. Okay, so these fragments are going to it is going to develop and form a new individual. Fine. And then we have discussed about the concept of vegetative propagation. Okay, as you could see here at the back of the screen, that this vegetative propagation means it is of different types, and we could see that there are two main types of this vegetative propagation. One is the natural vegetative propagation, another one is the artificial vegetative propagation, where in natural vegetative propagation you may see the vegetables like potato, ginger, these are going to develop on their own with the help of the stem. So natural vegetative propagation occurs in nature without the interference of the human beings. Okay, and this artificial vegetative propagation takes place with the help of the human beings, because of the human beings. Okay, so we are going to cut the stem of sugarcane and we are going to plant this in the soil. Similarly, grafting is also done, similarly layering is also done, similarly tissue culture is also done, and each of them is studied under a broad heading, means it is a very broad topic, but you all should have a superficial knowledge in class 7th. So I'll discuss this one by one, and I have taken this topic again today so that it becomes very clear for you all, because yesterday I have discussed only in the very small topic, as a very small topic in the last. Okay, so I just introduced the word of vegetative propagation. As I told you, that vegetative propagation is a long word where it consists of two parts. One is this vegetative and the second part is this propagation. Now what is the meaning of the word propagation? I yesterday told you about it. So this propagation means to increase in number. Okay, to increase in number. Now how it is going to increase in number? It is going to increase in number because of the process of reproduction with the help of the vegetative parts. Now here comes the knowledge of the vegetative as well as the reproductive parts of a plant. Now what was the vegetative part and what is this reproductive part of a plant? So it was very clear that the vegetative part means the part which was other than the flower. So flower is considered to be as the reproductive part. Okay, why reproductive part? It is because the reproductive organs of a flower is present inside it. And then what do you mean by the vegetative part? Vegetative part of a plant means it is the part except flower. So we are left only with the root, stem, leaves, buds, all these are the vegetative parts. Okay, so because of the presence of these vegetative parts, वी आर एबल टू प्रोड्यूस अ न्यू प्लांट सो वेजिटेटिवली. सो दिस इज़ नोन एज द वेजिटेटिव प्रोपिगेशन. सो इट इज़ ऑफ टू टाइप्स, नेचुरल वेजिटेटिव प्रोपिगेशन एंड आर्टिफिशियल वेजिटेटिव प्रोपिगेशन. नाउ लेट्स गो ऑन टू द फर्स्ट पार्ट दैट इज़ गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द नेचुरल एज वेल एज द artificial vegetative propagation. Now here this photograph is showing you about the stem cutting of rose. It is going to tell you about the stem cutting of money plant. Then you can see this potato is going to is sprouting from its eyes, and then we can see this ginger plant is also coming out from the stem of ginger. Bryophyllum leaf is also a kind of a leaf which is going to generate a new plant from its leaves. Okay, so this is one of the most special type of vegetative propagation. Okay, and then cactus stem also gives rise to a new plant with the help of its stem. Okay, now we will go on to the natural vegetative propagation. Now what is the meaning of this natural vegetative propagation? So here natural vegetative propagation means it is a way by which vegetative propagation is taking place, but it is taking place naturally. Okay, it is taking place naturally. Why it is taking place naturally? Because the root, stem and leaves are present, and new plants are going to arise from the stem, leaves, and it could arise from the various other parts. Okay, so we'll go one by one. So the first vegetative propagation is the propagation of propagation by leaves, okay, which takes place in the bryophyllum or the sprout leaf plant. So the first thing which we need to discuss here is when the leaves of some plants are buried inside the ground. Okay, so it is being buried inside the ground. Then what happens into the moist soil, then it is going to it and the stems are going to cut from its edge. Now once we are going to cut the stem, then what happens? So it is going to resemble to a new plant and it is going to develop from the margins of the leaves. Okay, so this is how the stem cutting is done. As you could see here in the diagram, where the stems of a rose plant is cut and then it is planted in the soil, and then after some time what happens, a new branch is coming out from the cut portion. Okay, so it is going to survive and give rise to a new rose plant. Similarly, we do this stem cutting in many flower plants, or we could also do this stem cutting in the money plants also. You just bring one stem and put it in the moist soil and you will be able to generate a new plant because of the stem cutting. Okay, so this is what is known as the stem cutting. Fine. Now next one more, this was the artificial mode of propagation, but I don't want to confuse you all here by the vegetative propagation which is taking place by leaves. Now here the vegetative propagation is taking place by the leaves, and these leaves are going to develop a new plant on its own, and this is only possible in the bryophyllum leaf, which you could see naturally. Okay, so this is done naturally. So this was the natural vegetative propagation by the leaves, where some of the leaves are buried inside the soil and then the margins are going to develop. Now what is present in the margin of the bryophyllum leaf? As you could observe the bryophyllum leaf, so you could see that there are notches present. So each of the notch is going to give rise to a new plant. Okay, so it is going to give rise to a new plant. So you could see here also that natural vegetative propagation is taking place in the bryophyllum leaf because of the notches which are present here. So these notches are going to develop a new plant, as you could see here in these parts. Okay, now what happens, this is going to develop a new plant. Okay, so this was the natural vegetative propagation with the help of the leaves. Okay, now we move on to the next part, that is the vegetative propagation by roots and bulb. Okay, now what is this roots and bulbs? So here I just wanted to tell you about the plants which could be vegetatively propagated, which could be vegetatively means it is vegetatively generated, or it produces a new plant with the help of roots. Okay, So the plants are going to generate with the roots, where the roots are going to give rise to the vegetative, means that it is going to give rise to a new plant from its stem. Okay, so what happens then, what happens here, the plants like potato, okay, dahlia, then the plants are going to develop from its roots and the bulbs. Okay, so you could see here it is taking place from the stem, it is also taking place from the roots. I just wanted to show you the next picture where you could see this is a root of dahlia. It is a flower plant which is going to generate a new plant from its root. Okay, but in the potato it is a kind of a stem. So this stem, it is a special type of stem which is present inside the ground, where you could see that the stem is always arising from the part of the which is above the ground. But this is an underground stem where this roots, this plant is going to generate from the small depression like places which is known as eyes of a potato. Okay, so these eyes of a potato is responsible for the generation of a new plant. As you could see that this is a season where you could see in the kitchens also, in if you go and just look, yesterday I show you one of the potato also from where the sprouting was done. So this sprouts are going to generate from the stem of the potato. Okay, as it is underground but still it is known as stem. And next, this was the vegetative propagation which is being seen from a bryophyllum leaf, and you could see that there are notches present in the leaves, and from each of the notch a new plantlet is coming out. And now if you are going to plant this plantlet into the soil, then it is going to generate into a new big plant. Okay, it will grow and form into an adult bryophyllum plant. Fine. So this was the natural way by which the plants are going to develop because of the stem, roots and the leaves. Okay, now what happens, you could see here again a new photograph which is being shown here, where you could see the picture of potato, ginger, leaf and many other plants like orchids are there, which this is a bulb which is going to generate a new plant from its bulb, especially the onion, garlic. So all these are having a small bulb like structure at the end, so we could see that the new plant is going to come out from the bulb part. Okay, so this is what is about the natural vegetative propagation. Now it is the time to move on to the next slide, and I must show you that there what is the advantage of vegetative propagation. Okay, as you could see that there could be as you could feel that there could be certain advantage of vegetative propagation. Now what could be the advantages of vegetative propagation? So here vegetative propagation is a thing because of which you could generate many plants at the same time. Okay, so you could generate the different plants at the same time. New plants are going to be generated, they could be exact copy of the parent plant, and it could be present from a single plant, because of which many of the plants could be generated at the same time. So large number of species could be generated. Next thing is that it takes less time to grow, because the plants which are developing from the seed, it requires more time if a plant is generating from a stem. You just cut up this much big long stem and you just plant it inside the ground, it is going to generate. So this takes less time. Now these advantages would be, again I'll discuss this when I'll teach you about the next topic, that is the artificial vegetative propagation. Okay, so these advantages will remain same whether it is a natural vegetative propagation or it could be the artificial vegetative propagation, and these advantages are going to increase also. How they are going to increase, I must first explain about the artificial vegetative propagation, then it will be very clear for you all to understand why it is advantageous to have this vegetative propagation artificially. Now these are some pictures which you could see here, and it's very easy to understand that what is the meaning of this artificial methods of vegetative propagation. As this picture was there, where you were able to see that the plants are these are cut and they are going to be planted into the soil, they're going to be sown into the soil, because of which what happens, a new plant is going to generate from the from the axial position of the stem. Okay, so this is very common process of artificial vegetative propagation, where the stem is going to cut, see, as it is going to cut and it is going to plant, it is going to be planted into the wet soil, where it is going to generate, after some time it is going to develop into a new plant, and it is going to develop as a completely grown plant, and it is going to take less time also, because you are already planting a stem, you're not planting a seed. Okay, so this was about the method of artificial way by which you are cutting, means human beings are involved in cutting process. So this method of artificial propagation is known as cutting method. So you cut the stem, you just plant it in the soil, and after some time what happens, it is going to develop into a new plant, and it is going to give rise to the flowers also. It could give rise to the fruits for which you are using this cutting. So the example where the cutting method is being done, this is very easy to recall from the previous knowledge, that you could see that mangoes are developed because of the stem cutting. Okay, rose are also developed because of the stem cutting. Bananas are there, sugarcane is there. It is used to cut, and then it is going to be planted in the soil, and it is going to generate into a new plant. Okay, now here you could see the diagram of stem cutting, where you could see that some plants are there. It is just cut, and you could see that small stems are being cut, and it is being sown into the soil, and after some time what happens, a new plant is going to be developed from these cut portion of the plant. Okay, now next, what is there, the stems, this vegetative propagation takes place with the help of the stem. Now the stem or the branches of the plant, they normally bear the buds in the axils. Now what is this axil? Axil means it is a notch, it is a corner from where the plants are going to give rise to a new plants. Okay, if one branch is there from this corner, so this is known as axil. So axils means it is a corner of the main stem and the branch stem from where a new plant is going to develop, a new bud like structure is going to come out. So that is why what happens, a new plant is going to generate from the axils of the leaves. Okay, axils of the leaves, or you could say axils of the stem. And it was very clear in this first picture. I must show this picture again, so you could see this. I have marked it also. So this is a place where the axils are there, axils, as you could see here. So these axils are going to generate a new plant. Okay, so it is generated from the corner of the stem, where this axil is present, and these axils are going to give rise to a new new leaves, because of which it is going to develop into a new shoot. Okay, so this buds are going to present in the axil, that is the point of attachment of the leaves and the node. Now what is a node? Node is a swollen structure which is present at the in between the leaves, in between the stem. As you could see that there are interruptions in between the stem, these interruptions are known as nodes. Okay, so if you just recall a plant, you could see that there are interruptions in between, and it is very commonly seen in which plant it is very clearly visible in a plant that whose name is sugar cane. Yes, so here sugar cane is a plant which is going to show you these nodes. Okay, these nodes are present. So each of this swollen structure is known as a node, and the place where between these two nodes is known as the internode. Okay, internode. So these nodes and internodes are present in the sugarcane, and you could see very clearly where these sugarcane is going to be cut from the portion of the nodes, from in between the two nodes, means it is going to be cut from the portion where the nodes are present. Okay, so we suppose that this is a node of a sugarcane. It is going to be cut from the internode portion, from here and here. Okay, and then it is going to be planted inside the soil. Now once they are planted inside the soil, what happens, a new plant is going to arise from these stem. from this cut portion of the stem. And from where they are going to arise? They are going to arise from the axil part. So axil is what? Axil is the it is a point of attachment of the leaves at the nodes. Now what is a node? I have told you just now that node is a swollen part at the base of the stem, at the all the portion of the stem. Okay, now vegetative buds, they are going to give rise to a new plant. So these plants, these buds consist of a short stem with an immature overlapping leaves, and they are folded and they can produce a new plants by vegetative propagation. As you could see here in the diagram also, that these plants are which are very small in their which are very tiny and they have overlapping leaves. Small leaves are going to come out from the axils, from the point of attachment, and then what happens, it is going to be generated in the form of a new plant. It is going to be generated in the form of a new plant. Okay, so that is all about the vegetative propagation, and this is how the stem cutting is done. So this is the process of artificial vegetative propagation, and its name is stem cutting. So it is also known as simply by cutting method. Stem cutting means you are cutting the stem and you are planting it. So this is known as stem cutting. Fine. Next, vegetative propagation is again one more term that is called grafting. So this is the diagram of grafting. First, so here as you could see, so here the grafting is done in the process by which two plants are joined together with the help of the moist soil, and they are being tied up. Now how it is being done, I must tell you first what is the method of doing this grafting. So this is a picture which is showing you about what is grafting. Grafting or the graft is known as something from outside. Okay, it is being grafted outside, it is being grafted, it is coming from somewhere and it is being joined to something else. Now how it is being done, we take two plants. Okay, now please understand the way by which the grafting is done. Stem cutting was very simple, you just cut a stem and just sow it into the soil. But grafting, it is a little bit complex type of a process where you need to take two plants. Two plants are taken of desired, it is being taken and it is of desired features. Now what are the desired features? First understand that desired features means the two main desired features are there. First one is that it should have a good root system, good root system, and the second thing is it should have a good shoot system. Okay, so the part which is below the ground is known as the root system, and the part which is above the ground is known as the okay, it is known as the shoot system. Now what are the desired key features? The desired feature was the good root system and the shoot system. Now why root system must be good? Root system should be good because it requires the plants to absorb more and more nutrients. It should have for absorbing the water properly, for absorbing the minerals properly, manures properly, we require a good root system so that it could absorb the things, it absorb the nutrients properly. So a good root is required. Next thing is that if a plant is having a good shoot system, now what is the meaning, why we are required good shoot system? Shoot system should be good because we need many branches. Okay, we need profuse branching, so many branches must arise. So why many branches are required? Because if you think about it, that if one single plant is there, and if you think about it is a rice plant or it is a wheat plant, it is a maize plant, so what happens, or if it is a fruit or vegetable plant, now what happens, the fruits and vegetables are coming on each and every stem. So if it has more stem, it means it will give you more fruits and the flowers. Okay, now if only one stem is there, it means it is going to give rise to only one flower. So we require many branches so that we get more production, we get more fruits. Okay, Now what happens, once we are going to get the good fruits, then if more stems are there, it means we are going to get more fruits. So we take two desired characteristics, one is the good root system, another one is the good shoot system, fine. Now what we need to do, so we cut this. Okay, now here only I'll introduce two words. The first word is that if a plant is having a good root system, the desired plant which we are taking for cut for grafting, and it has a good root system, so that is known as the stalk. This is known as the stalk, the part which is present, the plant which is having the good root system which it will take for grafting, and the next part which we are going to plant over it means it is having a good shoot system. So that part of the plant is known as the scion. So scion and the stalk is used for the grafting purpose. So I have introduced these two new words, the scion and the stalk. Now stalk means it is the good, it is a plant, desired plant which we have taken, and it has a good root system. And scion is a plant which is having a good shoot system, so that it is going to give rise to a new plant which is in which we could easily be able to give rise to a new plant. Okay, so that is why we are going to join these two plants with the desired characteristics. Okay, now what we are going to do, we are going to cut this in a slanting form. Now cutting could be done to increase the surface area. So why this slanting cut is being made? It is being made to increase the surface area of these two parts, so that it could join properly, it could join very easily. So we are going to join these cut portion, we are going to cut the scion, we are going to cut the stalk, and we are going to just join it. Put the stem on one over another and then tie it with the help of a moist soil. Then above it, you just tie it with the help of the bag, or it could be some cloth, or it could be the polythene, so that it could so that the bacteria should not enter, it should not harm the plants which you are grafting on one another. Now what happens, the very soon these are going to join with each other, and you are able to see your desired characteristics in one plant itself. So it has a good root system now, and it has a good shoot system now. So what happens, this is going to develop a new plant. Once it is being joined, it is going to give rise to a good variety of good plant is being produced, which is going to have a good shoot system as well as the root system. Okay, now this grafting is done in, mainly it is done in the plants like apples, it is done in rose, it is done in mangoes. Okay, so grafting is there where sometimes two plants are joined together, both of them can provide the desired, both of should have their desired characteristics and of the new plant. Now one of the plant remains rooted in the ground, this is known as stalk, whereas another is known as the which is going to provide essential nutrients, and another part which is above the ground is known as the scion. So these two are cut and then they are going to join, and this is known as the graft union. After some time, after some days, you could see, you will open this place where you have been tying this up. So what happens, you're going to see a new plant, a new plantlet is generated from this joint portion, and this joint is going to be sustained in its own way, and then you can see that a new plant is going to, new leaves are going to be generated from this part. And now if the plant is having a new leaves, so it is going to give rise to a new desired characteristics with the in the plant. So this is done mainly in the hibiscus, it is done in the rose, where one petal is going to give rise to a red colored flower, suppose that, and another branch is going to give rise to a yellow colored flower. Okay, so this happens just because of the grafting purpose. This happens because of the grafting process. Now next, there are some more artificial propagation methods. So we have discussed about two artificial propagation method, where this was one of the vegetative mode of propagation, from the stem which we have seen earlier. We just cut it with a sharp knife, and then we are going to plant this into a moist soil, and it is going to give rise to a new desired characteristics of plant, and means it is going to develop into a new plants into a new plant by because of the cutting. Okay, so this is done. This is being done in the plants like champa. It is being done in the plants like grapes. It is being done in the plants like sugarcane. Okay. Next is another method of propagation is known as layering. So this method is a very good method of the plants which is going to produce a new plantlet. This is called layering. Okay. Now what is this layering? Layer means to just cover it with something. Okay, you just cover it, layer it with something. So here how it is being done, another method of vegetative propagation of stem is by layering method. In this method, a mature branch of a plant, parent plant, is bent down and then it is covered with the soil. Okay, and then what has happened, the tip of the plant is kept above the ground and the root begins to develop from the branches and grows into a new plant. Now layering is a method which is done in the long slender branches which could bend easily, example jasmine. Okay, now here I will show you the method of layering, where how it is being done. So we are taking a plant with a slender stem. Okay, it should have a flexible stem. Yeah, just remember this, you should always take a plant with a flexible stem. Okay, now just bend it and cover it with the soil. As you could see here, you just bend it and cover it with the soil. You layer it with the soil. After a few days, you will see that a new small roots are going to develop from this part. And then you will see a new plant is going to come out from the cut portion, from the layered portion, not the cut portion, from the layered portion. Now if the new plants is generated from the cut, from this layered portion, you just cut the main stem. Okay, we cut the main stem, we cut the parent, we detach the new plant from the parent plant. Okay, and this generates, this develops into a new healthy plant just because of layering. So this is done in the long flexible stem like stem which is present in the plants like jasmine. It is present in the plants like mint. Okay, so it is done in many flowering plants which is having a long slender stem. Next, what is done, as you could see here, it is being layered, and then what happens, it grows into a new plant, a mature plant, and then we are going to cut this after some time from the parent plant. Okay, so we just take a plant, a branch which is long in its nature, and it is going to bend, it is going to bend, and it is going, the tip is remaining upside. Okay, so it is going to be bent, and then we are going to put it, we are going to layer it with the soil. After some days you will see that a small roots are going to develop from this part, and then it is going to generate a new small plant. Once you see that a new small plant is being generated, you just cut it from the parent plant. Once you're going to cut this, now what happens, this is free from the parent plant. Okay, so this was the parent plant and this is a new small plant. So this again, now this can grow easily, very nicely, because its root has been developed and its shoot is also now developing, because of which it could be easily being grown into a new plant. Fine. So this is what is about the vegetative propagation, artificial vegetative propagation. Now one more thing is left, that is the tissue culture, which I'm going to discuss in the next class. Okay, so this is done completely in the labs, and I'll tell you how it is being done. Okay children, so that's all for today's video. I will meet you all in the next video with the next topic to be discussed.